John Todd is a dynamic sports photographer who's managed to capture some of the biggest sporting events, from surfing to golf to soccer. His work has appeared in Sports Illustrated, ESPN, The New York Times, and the list just goes on. I sat down with him and asked him for his inside tips for outstanding sports photography that you can go right out and use.
How about composition and angles in terms of getting a great sports shot?
For sports, I think the key is to get, I always tell students that I teach, get low, get high. So if you're shooting soccer or football or any field sport, try to get as low as you can. If I could, I would lay down on the field every game, because a lot of times the players are looking down at their feet, looking down at the ball, or if they have their helmets on, it's hard to see. So you want to get as low as possible and get that low angle looking back up at the athlete, and that kind of gives them that superhero feel as well. Makes them look like giants.
Mm-hmm.
So that's one of the biggest keys. The other one is to get high. That'll help you clean up your backgrounds. Go up into the stands, shoot down on the field, get a nice green background as a backdrop, and also gives you a little bit of a different perspective.
And how do you get in there and draw the kind of emotions that you're looking for from your subject?
If you're doing a portrait, I think the smartest thing to do is to just talk with people for a while. Get to know them. Get them to trust you. Really show them who you are, and in turn, they will show you who they are. If you walk into a shoot with a lot of attitude or demanding that somebody, just turn it on for you, they can't do it. But if you walk in, establish a rapport with them, really show them, an honest personality of who you are, you're going to get the same in return. And that's where you try to capture. Another one is, you need to, I think all the video games I played as a kid really helped me out, because that high, hand-eye coordination is really important, and practice makes perfect. So a lot of times I'll just go out in the backyard and just practice focusing. Just like you're going to kick the ball around in the backyard or throw the football, if you've had your lenses, spend a half an hour just practicing quick focusing, because that's really the key to sports photography. I took one USA versus Ghana at the World Cup in Germany, 2006. And I was, at that point, I was just working on a tip that I got from David Bergman, who's a sports photographer out of New York. And it was kind of a one-handed grab. So you, in soccer or football, you're always shooting with two lenses, usually a 400-28, and then you have your 70-200 on your hip. And his key was that he would reach down, grab the 70-200 when he would see action right in front of him, bring it up with one hand, and be able to photograph one-handed. And that gave him a lot faster reaction. So I started trying out this tip. And so the players were running towards me, too tight for the 400. So I went down, grabbed with one hand, reached up, grabbed it, and got a picture of a player doing almost a bicycle kick right in front of me. And it's a fantastic, image, really shows the emotion and the power of the sport. And a funny thing about that shot is one of our other photographers was on the other side of the field photographing us. And it was only me shooting, and two other photographers were just had their jaw dropped watching the action because they couldn't get their cameras up fast enough. So using the one-handed up fast, that gave me one of my best shots that I love.
So John, what are some of the key points that you use every time you pick up a camera, or even before you pick up a camera?
There's two points. One is I like to think about what the client wants, and the other one is I like to think about what the image is I'm trying to produce. Ansel Adams talked about when he was photographing that he would think about the image in his mind's eye, and then he would use all the tools that he had to create that image. So if I'm shooting for a client, I'm going to say, hey, what do you guys want? They say, well, I want a sports figure to show the emotion and the action. So I'm going to take all the tools that I have, my cameras, my lenses, my computer, my software, and think about the end result before I even start shooting. Same thing when I'm shooting images for myself. I think about what is it I'm trying to do today? What am I trying to show? And then I line up all the tools I have to try to reach that goal. So I'm really thinking about the image before I even take it. When I'm on a shoot, though, a photo will develop, and I'll see an image I didn't think existed, or one image will lead me to another image. But really, before I go to a shoot, I'm trying to think about what is it I'm trying to produce, and then I try to capture that.
I hope you enjoy John's tips and will go out and put them to use right away. Thanks for joining us again. Be sure to subscribe now. Hit that subscribe button. You don't want to miss any of our new episodes. And please share, like, and leave your comments. I love hearing from you. And until we see you again on our next show, remember to get out and capture your own images of life.